Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how you can plan for IT projects and other related spending using Oracle IT Financial Management Cloud. Implementing a comprehensive, robust IT financial management process provides insight into how your company's IT service portfolio, vendor relations, and resource allocations influence the cost structure as a whole. Oracle IT Financial Management Cloud, or ITFM, aligns IT spend to run and grow the business, helping to strike that balance between strategic and operational demands. Benefits include: with features such as an end-user-owned allocation model, IT service catalog framework, and bill of IT invoice, you can influence demand for IT shared services via defensible and transparent IT chargebacks. Gain greater insight into IT spend and improve planning and forecasting through IT project planning, as well as IT spend planning and analysis. Quickly change assumptions to simulate the impact of decisions on running the business, growing the business, and transforming the business. Data management and built-in integration with your key IT and business processes allows you to leverage your existing investments and complements your IT strategy. I'll show you how our company plans our IT spend using ITFM. We use the customized navigation flow to plan and analyze our company's IT projects, measure performance, and monitor spending such as support, maintenance, and infrastructure. The navigation flow includes two clusters, IT planning and IT costing. Let's take a look at the tasks in IT planning. Here, we monitor and analyze IT spends, perform top-down and bottom-up planning, and get an overall visibility of our plans. The IT Spends Overview dashboard allows us to monitor spending and follow the Run, Grow, and Transform business model when planning our IT budget. Spend Targets is where we plan for global IT spending targets and design reliable IT spending forecasts by region and department, services and applications, cost pools, and projects. Easily perform mass allocation across regions and departments, services and applications, cost pools and projects. Plan for detailed bottom-up spending by services and applications. Modifying plan data updates the charts instantly. We directly input expenses on this tab. Monitor forecasts and plans on these tabs. IT spends are calculated using driver-based or trend-based assumptions. For example, the acquisition of server machines require the following drivers: IT server machine numbers and the maintenance cost per machine. Managing driver trends allow us to identify cost reduction opportunities. For example, I'll modify the assumption value for telecom storage. Review and compare plans against stretch goal and best case scenarios so you can make adjustments accordingly. Let's move on to projects. Here, you can allocate the overall IT plans by run, grow, and transform projects. Manage, calculate, prioritize, and approve IT and capital projects in this section. High-level information is displayed on the IT Projects Overview tab. Manage labor, material, and other costs in Project Costs and Benefits. You enter detailed driver-based information on these tabs. Directly input project expenses on this page. Then, review or manage financial and non-financial benefits. Next, chargebacks. With chargebacks, our company can allocate costs of internal IT services, hardware, software, or maintenance to the business unit in which they are used. You can plan for IT chargebacks using drivers and trends to determine what factors are driving costs and budgets accordingly. We plan for service volumes and rates to derive chargeback by consumer. On this tab, we directly input plan revenue for specific services and applications. Then, review the overall chargeback plan on this page and chargeback surplus in income statement format on this page. With analysis, we can monitor progress, performance, and review financial and non-financial benefits, which helps determine if it is worth investing in a specific IT project. On this tab, we review the summary of detailed plans across all regions and compare it to the overall target plan. Let's move on to IT costing. Here we have two cards, IT cost dashboards and IT cost reports. On a summary level, the IT cost dashboards provide embedded analytics that organize and present profitability and cost analysis in an easy-to-consume manner. Project's overview displays a quick breakdown of run versus build project costs. Run projects shows which run projects are consuming the higher costs, as well as the department and accounts the costs are being allocated from. In this example, hosting infrastructure accounts for 33% of total run project costs. In run projects overview, we see most of the hosting infrastructure costs are consumed by the hardware infrastructure team and come mostly from compensation, salaries, wages, fringe benefits, and payroll tax. Let's take a look at IT cost reports. Here are predefined reports delivered with IT financial management. I'll open Bill of IT. With this report, our UK sales director can review the company's Bill of IT statement for December. For each line item, she can see the service being provided, the driver metric used for billing, and how the charge per line item is derived. This transparency gives us insight into the value and costs delivered by IT. Our business units gain visibility into how their utilization of IT services impacts IT costs, allowing them to control their IT service consumption for overall company efficiency. The Service Cost Summary Report provides our IT services manager a multidimensional view of the services her team provides to the company. You can drill down the line items to return granular level data. In network connectivity, we can see the resource information, such as routers and switches that make up the total service cost for the team. I'll drill down one more level to view all run projects that sum up the router and switch costs. This level of transparency enables our IT manager to follow the flow of funds through the model to manage cost return. We can view the same project detail granularity in the project cost summary report. We see the breakdown between run and build projects, as well as some of the attributes assigned to the projects, such as the project type and project manager. Drilling down on project costs displays the entity which it is sourced from. Next, I'll drill further down to review the actual accounts that make up a department's expenses, such as salaries and benefits. In this tutorial, you saw how you can plan for IT projects and other related spending using Oracle IT Financial Management Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.